Hey, welcome back everybody to another episode of Elden Ring. Last we left off, we basically just started, right? We made the character, we tackled that first boss, we made it all the way to our first sort of proper grave, or grace, sorry, grave. We've died a few times as well. We got here, we got Torin, who we can jump and double jump now. And we're going to start working our way. Ooh, look, you can see him in the sky here. We're going to start working our way through these checkpoints and see if we can navigate ourselves through another series of combative, horrible decisions. Oh, yeah, we put all of our stats right into vigor. One thing I notice, I always want to know, if I watch somebody else playing Elden Ring, I'm always curious what level they are, so I'm going to try to showcase the level at the beginning of every episode here. Yeah, we're going to tackle this area, see if we can knock out some of these guys. A much stronger attack on him. I feel like that could have been easier. Okay. Lord Sworn's greatsword. I don't know, this club's pretty nice. Let's check it out. So we can't use it. 16 strength. We've got 10. Okay. So we'll hold off on that one. I know that guy right there, right above my head. He has a horn. That will alert everybody to kill me. So let's avoid him. Thought I saw an item. Just a message. A couple of guys over here. I'm gonna have to try not to whisper when I'm sneaking. My default is let's get the non first. Oh! That didn't last long. The Marika is at the top of the hill. I think I just want the grace. Yeah, daylight. Okay, let's try this guy one more time. See if we can just get a cleaner kill. Oh my gosh, is that my message from the beginning of the game? Oh! Welcome, oh welcome. Some other person. Well, that's quite exciting. Oh, they just see me right away. Oh wait, or do they? Okay, so a potion fills half my health. See if I can back up into my... Nice! And whop! Gotta get that shield broken. There it is. This chest. A flail. Another weapon we can't use. 18 dexterity, 16 strength. It's asking me to make a decision. Who do I want to be? Who do we want to be? We want to be someone who kills the rest of these people, though. Oh, he already sees me. No, no, he doesn't. No shield. You're an easier one. You do have a shield. Oh, I tried to do the wind up. My strength days. Goodness, goodness. I am just not getting past this shield. I roll. No, I've got more people. I'm not sure if I was two-handing the weapon just then. I should be doing that. Down here. Off her legs. What? Adding skills with a whetstone knife. Ooh, we got a whetstone knife. You can use Ashes of War to grant your armaments new skills at Sites of Grace. An armament can only have one skill. Any skill it previously had will be removed. An armament's type determines what skills it can have. Some special armaments have unique skills and cannot be granted new ones. Adding affinities. With a whetstone knife, you can use Ashes of War to grant affinities to your armaments at Sites of Grace. This way, you can alter an armament's attack and affinity, boost attribute scaling, and more. An armament's type determines what affinities it can have. Some special armaments, like those with unique skills, cannot be granted new affinities. And then, this must be an Ash of War Storm Stomp. And my whetstone knife. Cool, okay. So I guess, so then that makes the Barbaric Roar. That's my current Ash of War. Which I like. Let's see if we can, like, step away. Okay, no one's here. Ashes of War. Storm Stomp. Grants affinities and skills to an armament. That's generic. Oh, here we go. This Ash of War grants an armament the quality, affinity, and the following skill. Storm Stomp, one of the skills that can channel the tempests of storm barrels. Stomp hard on the ground and kick up a momentary storm. Usable on all melee armaments. So then what do we have? No, I'm not that. How do I see... There, Barbaric Roar. Let use a bestial roar to rally the spirit and increase attack power. While active, strong attacks change to savage combo attacks. I like being a savage combo person. it, that's why it did that once before. I remember that. Four more, that's all there was. Yeah. Did you drop my one thing? A helmet! The helmet on. Why not? Let's see if I can. That was pretty good. That gets the shield off. That's quite nice. I'm not gonna worry about the main guy. I feel like he's a little above me. And we've got stuff to do. Might go right here. Let's go explore. Combat. Oof. This isn't going well for me. Ooh, vanquishing enemy groups. Vanquishing an enemy group will replenish your flasks. The number and type of flasks to be replenished varies depending on the enemy group. You cannot replenish more flasks than your maximum amount allows. Beast. Oh, is that from you? Aww. I don't want that. I want your sword and your cool feather hat. Oh, there's another one. They're pretty. He's part of the camp. We hide in the grass, right? What's the point? He sees me! Oh, he did bestial barbaric roll. Too. So I might not edit out all of the deaths, but I will certainly shorten the, like, cut time between when I die and when I come back alive. Gloves! Nice! We are getting this armor put together. What were you going? A cookbook, a number one cookbook, the number one cookbook.
Ooh, what's that?
Go away! Hide on this rock. Oh, you don't care. Oh, wait, is he leaving? I think I want him to leave. Yeah, and then we can kill all these wolves. That's far more level 5. I think as the wretch, I have to sort of pick my fights a little more clever. Until I can kind of like, so like I think the starting classes start at like level 10 or 9. So if I can just get sort of, you know, and then they would progress a little bit, so maybe like level 12, I will feel like anybody in this sort of starting league. Always look for caves. This little statue. Guide and gatekeeper for those returning to the roots. We are returning to the roots. Wants us to go down there. Bears? Can we kill a bear? Go like over here. Maybe we'll. He's alone. Yeah, come over here. Hefty beast bow. Now I can take you in then. More gold poo. Trina's lily. It's blocked. Yeah. Run. Okay, now we go down. Oh, there it is. You can see it. Oops. Okay. Looking for caves. backwater catacombs. Definitely. Still don't know what to spend my runes on. Not sure. If we're gonna go strength or dexterity though. Aye! The other. No. Ah! Heal. Root resin. Times five. Somewhere a heavy door has opened. Oh, I did it! Didn't even see it. It's gonna be another one for those two. Probably three. I can just skip that side since I've got that item. I do. Oh, there's that potential third one. Let's use our camera. Ooh, there's my money. Okay. So close. Thank you. Okay. First room. Second room. It's like a horror video game. We can just gun it. I just want this guy now. We don't care about the rest of you. Yeah. We got this. Run, run, running. We're just gonna run. Okay. they are a lot closer this time. Oh, I gotta get these rooms closer to the entrance. Oh, he's shooting me through the wall! Calling bell, you can use ashes to summon various spirits. Summoning typically consumes FP. You can summon one type of spirit at a time. You cannot summon during multiplayer. Banished Knight Engval? Is that him? Did I get his spirit? Engval. His name was something else. I've already forgotten. Let's go back to the entrance. Okay, I'm gonna rest at this grace. I think my dog is looking for a walk, so we're gonna go outside and we'll come back in just a little bit. Stay tuned.